First we will study about the tools used in a fitting shop. Usually the tool, first tool comes the measuring and marking tools. Usually in a fitting shop for linear measurement steel rule is used for rough measurement. You can see here steel rule, it is marked in millimeters. Up to 100 millimeter, it is again 1 mm is divided into 2, that is 0.5 mm. That is the least count we can measure with this instrument. You can just hold the item. Suppose I want to measure the width of this one, you hold like this one and take the measurement. Now this is 35. Okay. Next item is to check the angle of an item. Suppose you want to check the angle of a piece, 90 degrees, you can use this one. See, this one consists of a body and a blade. You have to hold in such a way that your finger should not interfere with this face of the body. Always hold like this, so that this face will be free from your fingers, and always the blade should come at the top of the top when you hold like. Then place the one of the side here like this and check at the top. Suppose you want to check the 90 degree of this corner, you keep like this and check at the top. If it is touching everywhere, then it is 90 degree. Now it is not touching everywhere, only this portion is touching. That means this is more than 90 degree. If it is less than 90 degree, that will be touching here only. Then that is less than 90 degree. Now it is a little more than 90 degree. We have to reduce a little from here. Remove a small amount of material from here so that it will be touching everywhere. See, I will take another piece and you can check. This is another piece I am checking here. You can see it is perfectly aligning everywhere. It is touching top as well as the side. That means this corner is exact 90 degrees. Okay. The name of this equipment is tri-square. Tri-square is used to check the 90 degree angle of an item. The next important item is the vernier caliper. This I think you might have studied from the lower classes. It is having one main scale and one vernier scale, and also two types of jaws are there. This is called the outside measuring jaw and this is called inside measuring jaw. Suppose you want to measure the hole of an item, you can use this one and the reading can be done here. And if you measure the outside, you can use like this. And there is a locking mechanism is also there. You can lock the item after measuring. See, if you want, I can tell you the how to find out the least count. In this one, the mm is marked on the main scale, and 49 mm in the main scale. This is the main scale. 49 mm in the main scale. You can see here, 49 mm in the main scale is divided into 50 equal parts in the vernier portion. 50 equal parts. So one part in the vernier portion is a little less than 1 mm. See, that is the size will be 49 by 50 mm. So a little less, 49 by 50 is the size of a one graduation in the vernier portion. Now I will tell you how to find out the least count. Least count is equal to 1 main scale division minus 1 vernier scale division. 1 main scale division is 1 mm. So 1 minus 49 by 50. That is the least count of the this vernier caliper. Now I will tell you 1 by 50 can be taken as 50 by 50 and minus 49 by 50, that is equal to 1 by 50. 1 by 50 is the least count of this one. this item. 1 by 50 millimeter. 1 by 50 we can convert it into decimal. You multiply numerator and denominator by 2, then you will get a 2 by 100. 2 by 100 is equal to 0.02. That is the least count of this equipment. For rough measurement of to take the inside of an item, suppose you want to take the inside dimension of this one. See, you can use an inside caliper. This is called inside caliper, ordinary type. But you cannot read the measurement directly from this one. But you have to see, now this is exactly going. Now you can compare with a ordinary steel rule. How much is the size? This is 61 millimeter. The name of the equipment is inside caliper with a spring loaded inside caliper, because we can rotate this one and automatically it will be expanding, and in order to contract this one you can tighten in the other direction. Similar type is available for outside measurement. Outside measurement, the size will be something like a curvature like this, and instead of curvature in the outside, it will be in the inside. That is used to measure the outside diameter. See, in the sheet metal, we have already studied about this one. This is called a scriber, a pointed tool used to mark a line. Suppose I want to mark a line on a work material. You hold the hold a straight edge and mark it. You can get a line here. Okay. For that, a scriber is used. And a For before starting a hole, suppose you want to drill a hole, you have to punch, mark with a center punch. This is called a center punch. The included angle of the center punch is 90 degrees. You have already studied a similar item, that is called a prick punch, and the included angle is in between 30 to 60 degrees. That is mainly used in a sheet metal. This is used in usually used in fitting shop, a center punch. These are the main measuring tools. Of course, there are other measuring tools like protractor, bevel protractor, etc. for measuring and marking. Next item is the cutting tools used in a fitting shop. The main item used in a fitting shop is a file. File is an item with many number of teeth over the periphery of the tool. You might have seen this one earlier, I think. This is called a flat file. Flat file, there are, according to the number of teeth per unit length, this is classified into rough file, then bustard file, second cut, etc. See, if the item having only 8 teeth per inch, then it is called a rough file, 8 teeth per inch. You take in 1 inch, this is 1 inch. You count the item, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. If it is 8, then it is called a rough file. If it is having 12, it is called a bustard file. This is a bustard file, second cut. Second cut means in one direction as well as the other direction, cutting is given. That is called a bustard file. Second cut, bustard file. This is single cut. You can see only one direction cutting teeth are there. In the other direction, no teeth is provided. This is called single cut file. See, as I told earlier, the second cut, then smooth is there. That is about 24 teeth will be there. Then it is called a smooth file, and a dead smooth, it is having 35 teeth per inch, then it is called a dead smooth. And a super smooth is also there, that is more than 50, then it is called a super smooth file. If you file with a super smooth, you will get a very fine surface in the item. You can see here. See, and this I have used the bastard file. If you are using a smooth smooth file, you will get a smooth surface. And if you use a dead smooth, better than the ordinary second cut file, you will get. These are called the files. This is called a flat file. I am not describing the details of this one. There are the five parts are there. This is a tang, heel, face, edge, etc. These are names of the items. Okay, I am not explaining all those things because of time limitation. Now we will have another shape which is called a half round. See, if you cut here and look from the edge, you can see a sector of a circle. Then it is called a half round, even though it is not exact half, but the name is half round file. This is a round file. If you cut and look from the edge, you can see it is a circular. Then it is called a round file. This one you can see is a triangular file. If you cut and look from the edge, you can see it is a triangle. It is called a triangular file. Another main equipment used in a fitting shop is a hacksaw. Hacksaw is used to cut the material. Suppose you want to cut an item like this one. What do you have to do? You hold the item in the bench vise. This also comes under fitting, bench vise. It is an item, work holding device. If you rotate the handle in the clockwise direction, the gap will be going on reducing, and you can hold the item like this and tighten the item. It is working on the principle of screw. One screw is inside this one, and a screw and a nut. When you rotate this one, the threaded rod will be advancing, and that will be fixed with the movable jaw. Not exactly fixed, but it can be rotated, but no axial movement will be there. So you can hold like this one, and you can cut the item. You have to mark the item where you have to cut. Then you move the item to and fro. Usually the forward stroke cutting action will take place. You have to tight it properly, otherwise it will be difficult to cut. You can see an arrow here. This arrow should be always in the away from you. That means this is the cutting direction. When the cutting takes place in the while moving in this direction. So you can see this one. And see, cutting is going on. You can see here. The name of the item is hacksaw. There are two types of hacksaws are coming nowadays. One is called a 24 TPA. This is, you can see it is written as 18T. 18T means 18 teeth are in an inch. In 1 inch, you can count the teeth number as 18. And 24 is also there. 24 is used to cut thin material. The thickness is more, you can use 18. As well as if the material is soft, you have to use 18. If it is hard, you have to use 24. In order to do the small works, we can use a needle file set. In needle file set, various shapes of files are available. For example, this is a triangular file, this is a square file, and again a triangular file, a flat file is there. Like that, many shapes will be available, so that any shape of slot or hole can be made using the filed and cleared by using the small file. This is called a needle file. For example, if you want to make a duplicate key, you can use this one to make the duplicate key. I will tell you the methods of filing. One is called straight filing. In straight filing, you stand like this one, how I am standing, just in front of the bench vise, and keep the file straight and move the file pressing downwards. You hold the handle in the right hand and you press with your thumb or hand here, place the hand here and give a downward force and move the file forward. On the same place you file it. This is called a straight file. You stand in the in front of the bench vise and your right hip can be brought about 45 degree like this. Then you will be holding the file like this. This angle will be 45. Then move the file forward as well as laterally. This is called cross file. The last method is, I will tell you, if you are doing like this, there is a tendency of rocking the file like this one, moving the file, because every moment the force will be different. When I am pressing downwards, the force into this much distance, the next moment it will be force into this distance, so going on changing force and the distance. So there is a rocking action like this. The after effect will be, instead of getting 90 degree to this surface, you will have a curvature like this, round shape. It's a process. See, actually our requirement is like this. This is the side of the item and this is the place where we are filing. Instead of getting like this one, you will be getting something like this one due to rocking of the file. So in order to avoid that one, in the straight filing method, what I told you earlier, the straight method, this will be more, the crest forming will be more. But if you file with the cross filing method, that will be a little less, but you cannot avoid truly, fully. In order to avoid that one, what you have to do in the final stage, you have to draw another method, that is called draw filing. In draw filing, you keep the file like this one, in the straight filing method, then hold like this one, instead of handle and here, and draw the file like this one. In that case, you can see only at the center will be touching the file first. After going on doing like this, the touching will be everywhere. It becomes 90 degrees to the side. If you shift like this one, you can see it will be touching everywhere. First, it will be touching only at the center part. That is the filing method. What are the filing methods? Straight filing, cross filing and draw filing. Suppose I want to cut a metal of large length. Using the hacksaw will be difficult. And we can use two or three methods. But in our shop, we don't have any laser cutting machine or gas cutting machine, etc. So what we will be using, a chisel. This is called metal cutting chisel. You place the item in a plane surface and draw the line where we want to cut. Then using a chisel and a hammer. See, you have to use a large hammer, not like this one. You strike the over the line, going on striking and change the position throughout the line. If the thickness of the metal is more, then you can cut in the reverse side also. Rear side also you have to cut. Then keep somewhere like this one and strike this here, then you can cut the metal. This is another chisel, this is called diamond point chisel. This is used to make a groove in a metal. Suppose you want to make a groove here, then you keep the item like this and move the leg, cut like this, then you will get a groove here. In many cases, we have to tighten an item in a place. For that, usually a threaded hole is required. In order to make a threaded hole, first we have to select the size of the bolt we have to use. For that, you can use a steel rule. In the rear side, you can see some tap to drill, tap drill. Some relation is given. From that, you can select the size of the drill bit you have to use and make the hole. Then, using a tap, this is called a threading tap. You can make the hole with the thread. For that, you can use a, this is called a die set. You can use the item, tighten the item and make the hole with the thread. For making thread, you can hold it in the vise. This is not the actual size of hole, but I will show you how to do. You just keep the item and start doing like this. Finally, you will get the threaded hole. Can you see it is cutting here? Up to the last point, you cut it. While cutting, you should rotate the item not only in one direction, rear direction also you have to cut and increase the size properly. You will get the threaded hole. Cut the thread inside. In order to cut the thread outside, suppose you have to make a bolt for specific size, you can use an item called a die. This is called a die. Can see the item. This is a die. This can be fixed here, fitted here, and hold the item in the bend vise and rotate the over the cylindrical item. Then you will get the threaded bolt. Today we will be making a V joint in our fitting shop. In order to make the V joint, you will be provided with a workpiece of size 50 by 50, 50 mm width and 50 mm length. Then you have to make one of the corner exact 90 degree. For that, what you have to do, select one of the machine cut side. Here you can see machine cut side is this one as well as this. Some projection is here that you should remove it first by filing. See, I have already removed the projection. Now take one of the machine cut side. This is rolled side. See, this is rolled side. You can see some irregularities is there. The edges are not sharp. Here the edge is sharp. You can see this. Edge is sharp. So you take the item sharp with a sharp edge as best side. Any one side you can select. And mark with a single punch. You can use this is to avoid any difficulty while filing. You may change the side. So you mark this as best side with a single punch mark at the middle of the item and about 5 or 6 away from the edge. Single punch mark. And keep like this, it should come in your right side. Then keep the tri-square, body of the tri-square where we are punching, and check the top side. You can see there is a large gap here. So that means that this is less than 90 degrees here. What you have to do, you remove a little from here so that it will be touching everywhere. The blade will be touching everywhere. That means you have to remove a little from there. This side we can put it as side number 2. Otherwise, what will happen is, for that you punch 2 punches. So this is our first side, then this is our second side. If you are not putting the punji mark here, instead of filing here, what you will do, sometimes you may file here. So in order to avoid that one, you mark the sides. Then you keep the item in the bench vise. See, we have to remove a little from here because the blade is not touching here. That means here it is more height than here. So what you have to do, remove a little from this side. It is not enough. Again you keep the item and do it the same process again. You have to file a little more, then only you can get the item. See, I have already filed and corrected the item. You can see this one. See, it is touching everywhere. No gap is here. That means this corner is now, it is exactly 90 degree. This is exactly 90 degree. Now what you have to do is, you have to draw another line parallel to this one. That means this parallel to this means here. So then sometimes you may be getting a line something like this one. Then you have to remove from here. If it is exactly parallel to this one, then sometimes you will be getting a parallel line. Then you need not do anything, only finishing should be done. Like that you can make all the corners 90 degrees. After that you can keep this one in the vernier height gauge and draw parallel. Now what you have to do is, this direction, the rolled direction, rolled means without filed, no filing is done this side, you can see it. And the single punch mark you keep here and mark at 50 mm. You take the item at 50. Now it is 50. You mark a line at 50. Not only one side, both sides you can mark 50. Okay, then what you have to do? Take 48. Then adjust exactly. Now it is 40, tighten it. Then keeping the 2 punch mark side, mark 48. See. Not only one side, both side you mark. Now punch along the line about 5 mm apart. It is deep punch mark. You can use the distance at about 5 mm throughout the line. Not only one side, rear side also you punch. You punch throughout the line at about 5 mm. Okay. Similarly, this side also. All the sides you have to punch. Okay. Here and as well as here. Both sides. Now keep the item in the bench vise. And use the rough file. Rough file is not available, then you can use a bustard file. You go for straight file. This is in straight filing, material removal rate will be more. So you have to use the straight filing method. You have to file it in such a way that the half of the punch mark has gone. Because we are putting the punch mark on the line. So half punch mark will be on this side and half will be in the other side. Other side means right side of the line and the left side of the line, half. So you should remove half the punch mark so that you will get the 48 by 40. While filing, you have to use always tri square to check when and there you can. Our aim is to make a V joint like this. From the already filed item, you have to make a V joint like this. Can you see this hole we will be providing at the end? See, V joint. This is called a female V portion, and this is called a male V portion. Then you will join together. Then there should not be any gap here. Of course, you do your best. Now you have to transfer this size of the item in the given piece. The drawing is given, and you have to transfer that drawing into this workpiece. See, now the size of the workpiece is 48 in one direction and 50 in the other direction. 48 in this direction and 50 in this direction. What you have to do is, you draw a line at the middle of the 50 wider side. That means one will be 25. This is 25. This is 25. Then cut through the line. Now take 25 in the vernier height gauge. This is 25. Tighten it. Then mark 25 on it. Not only one side, other side also you mark. Now take the item to workbench and put the punch mark along the 25 mm line. You can do it. The distance can be up to 5 to 8 mm distance. In between the punch mark can be 5 to 8 mm, no problem. Then you cut the item. While cutting the item, you see that it is kept in one side. Do not keep like this. Then what will happen? You can see here some cutting mark is came. So in order to avoid that one, it's better to hold like this. Then using a hacksaw, you just put your thumb here like this one. Then start cutting on the line. See, our aim is to make one piece like this one from the already cut piece. What you have to do is, here the width is given as 11 mm. So you draw a line at 11 mm from this bottom. 11 mm. I'm drawing with a chalk. You have to draw with a vernier height gauge a line at 11 mm. Now draw a line at the center of the item. This is 48, so you will take 24 and draw a line like this. After that, what you have to do, this width is given as 11. So you keep like this and draw a line at 11. Similarly, keep this like this one and draw a line at 11. Then our total size here it is given as 24. So take the line at 24. That means exactly it will come very near to the already cut portion. Then what you have to do, join, put a punch mark there, then put another punch mark here. Join together with a scriber and a steel rule. Using a scriber, you can draw the line. See, this is the scriber. What you have to do is, we have already put a punch mark here. You keep a steel steel rule like this one and mark like this. Similarly, this side. We have already have a crossing point here. We will be putting a punch mark here. And one punch mark already done here. Join together. So, we will be getting all the lines like this. Now, we have to remove this portion. For that, you keep the item vertically and cut up to this punch mark or the starting line we have done. Up to here, you have to. This portion is not required. Similarly, this portion is not required. So, cut up to here. Similarly, cut from here to here. That time, this portion will be void. Similarly, cut from here to here and here to here. Why? Before cutting, what you have to do? You have to punch with the center punch along the line. And cutting should be done, do not touching the line, but about 1 mm away from the line. So that we can finish it with a file. In order to get exactly, we have to use a file and make it proper. See, I am setting the vernier height gauge at 11 mm. You can see this is at 11. Now tighten the it. I keep the workpiece like this one and draw a line at 11. It's better to draw on both sides, otherwise you may make mistake. 11. This side also we required 11. The other side also you required 11. Rear side also you draw the line. Now 24 is required. So take the 24 on the vernier height gauge. Tighten it. Draw a line at 24. Like this. Rear side also. Not only that, here also 24 is required. The total width is 48, so 24 is required here also. So you will be getting crossing point 1 here, 11, 11. Here similarly 11, 11. Here. Here 24 here, 24 here. This 3 points you already got. Then join that with a steel rule and a scriber. So this is the item. This portion we need not required. Similarly, this. Okay. Now cut and remove the item and file it properly to make the V shape, inverted V shape. This is inverted V shape. A matching V-shape is required for the other piece. This is the item we want to transfer to this one. Here also, the width of this one is given as 11. So you can draw a line like 11. Similarly, this to this, it is 11. And this line is also at 11. So, 1, 2, 3, 11 lines are drawn. Not only this side, the other side also required. Another thing, what you have to do, a line of at 24 mm, the middle of the item. So, this is the item. Now, what you have to do, you draw another line at 24 here. Now, what you have to do is, you will be getting a crossing point here, this and this crossing point. You join punch with the center punch here as well as here. Similarly, you punch a punch mark here and here. So you will be getting like this. So this portion is not required. This portion. While drawing the lines with a vernier height gauge, don't forget to draw the line in the rear side also. And always put a punch mark along the line where we want to cut. Here our cutting line is this one, this. Similarly this one. So put a punch mark here. Using the center punch, you can mark deep mark here as well as deep mark here. Then keep the item like this one. See, we have marked in the other piece with this center punch along the line we want to cut. Similarly, in this also you have to mark with the center punch on along the line where we have to cut. This is the line we want to cut. So mark on the line like this. I already marked. You can see the marking by these dots are the marking. Okay, now we have to cut and remove this portion. See, this is the final mark for cutting. Final mark for cutting. This much I will show you the sample. You can see it properly. See, now you can see the line through which we have to cut and remove this portion. This portion is not required. This is a sample, or the dimension is already marked with vernier height gauge here, and this is the final line we have to cut. For that, what you have to do? You take the item to bench vise. In order to cut the item, if you are keeping like this, there is a problem. When you are trying to cut here, this will be slipping because it is a slanted portion. So what you have to do is, you first keep it straight itself, then and you make a small marking here. Don't mark on the mark ending, line ending, but a little away from the line, inside unwanted portion. Keep the item vertically. While keeping the vertical, you better to use a pry square to adjust it properly. Now the cutting line is vertical. Now tighten the line. Do not cut on the line because we have to file it and make it proper. Proper. Okay. So you try to cut. See, you can see about 1 mm is away from the line. This is unwanted portion. Similarly, you can mark here and also cut along the line. You can keep like this, and what we have done here, similarly, you cut here. See, now cutting is over, but a little more is here to remove. What you have to do, keep that place in like this one, in horizontal manner. And you have to remove up to the line. You have to file this portion till the exact line is arrived, or half the punch mark has gone. What you have to do, you use this, using this file, there is a problem. This edge will be cutting this side. First side filing should not be any problem. You can file it till the line is arrived. See, after that you have to file a little and check with the pry square that this is cutting in a proper manner. Everywhere it is touching. See, after completing this one, what you have to do? You file this side. Is the line is around. At that time you don't use this file. What will happen is this edge will be cutting this side, which is already we have finished. So replace this file with a triangular file or a half round file, so that this will not affect the other side. But this will take a little more time. So while starting the item, where more material has to be removed, then use this one before starting. And a less item, you use this file or a triangular file, so that the other edge will not be cut away by the file. This is the procedure. See, we have marked a 24mm line here. Sometimes it may not be available to punch the item because the line will be coming very near to the edge. If available space is available, you punch it or you fix here until the line is arrived, you file it properly. While filing, always check whether you are filing in the right direction by checking like this. See, we have completed the item and we got the item like this one. We'll be getting like this. See, after completing, you can see the punch mark, half punch mark is available on the workpiece. Half we have already filed and removed. Similarly, you have to make the male piece also. This is called the male piece. Also, by marking along the line and cutting the item. Suppose I am marked like this, and punching also to be done along the line, you have to cut. Then cut the item very near to the line. Don't cut on the line. Always give a little gap to finish the item with the file. Cut the item. Similarly, cut on this one. To cut this one, it is better to keep horizontally and start with a groove. Not on the line, it should be coming a little away from the line. Now keep the item vertically. For verticality, you can check with the tri-square and adjust it properly. Then cut with it faster. After cutting, you file it in and make it like this.
Okay.
For filing, you should be careful what you have followed in the other piece. Always use the triangular file or a half round file, otherwise the other side will be etched away by the file. See, after completing this, actually there should not be any gap here. You can see there is no gap here, but a small problem came here. That should not occur. This is done by your previous batch students.